Hello, Roadrunners! It's Friday, August 27th. Welcome to the first Roadrunner Report of the school year.
Today we have
an interview with Ms. Emmrich,
a report on the student's door,
and a skit reviewing school rules,
and much more on this week's Roadrunner Report.
Arby, did you hear that Aaron interviewed Miss Emmrich this week?
No, I didn't. Was it interesting?
Yeah, she's been teaching for 5 years.
Let's cut to the clip.
Hey, Roadrunners. It's Aaron, and today I'm here with Miss Emmrich. She teaches 7th and 8th graders. So, I wanted to ask you the first question. What is it like being a teacher?
I think being a teacher is very exciting. I enjoy it, and every day is kind of like a new day because you never know what's going to happen, what new thing is going to come up, and conversations you're going to have with your students. So it's exciting.
What inspired you to be a teacher?
My mother was a teacher. She taught first grade, and I helped her in her classroom when I was in high school, and I just always enjoyed working with kids. So I just knew that I wanted to be with kids somehow, and since my mom was a teacher, I just decided to follow in her footsteps as well.
If you hadn't become a teacher, what would be a different career opportunity for you?
I've thought about that before. I don't know if I've ever would have succeeded in this area, but I do enjoy kind of like the forensic science, and I've always enjoyed watching those TV shows and how they solve things and do the digging and the researching. So maybe something like that, but I don't know.
What do you teach in your classroom? Like, what do you do?
Well, I have a lot of different subjects. I teach ELA, and I do US history and world history, and I also do coding. So I just kind of am doing in that class whatever the curriculum is asking me to do on that particular day. So a lot of different things.
Did you have a different career before teaching, or was it your first job?
Teaching was my very first job, but some of you might find that I am a familiar face because I have been here for 5 years, but I was as a para. I was a classroom helper, basically. And so now this year I'm stepping back into teaching, putting my teaching hat back on.
Why did you become a helper in the first place?
Good question. I was a teacher, went and taught right out of college. And then I started a family, stayed home with my family, and my kids are getting older, and I thought as they were getting older, I'd get back to work, but I thought I'd just start off as a para where I have the freedom to just leave at the end of the day and not have to worry about lesson planning and things like that. And then Miss Hess left this last year to go to the DO, and so I thought, well, maybe this is my opportunity to go back into teaching. So that's okay. Why I decided to go from para to teaching again.
Well, that's all the questions I have for you today.
Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
All right.
Wow, that was really interesting.
I know. I didn't know she does many different subjects.
Now it's time for the man on the street question.
What's the question this week?
The question is, what do you think about the student's door?
That's a great question. I can't wait to see what others have to say.
Hi, I'm Aubrey Shuping. I'm here with
Jaylene.
And Lucas.
Okay. What do you think about the student's door?
It's good. It is good. Never been there before, but I could tell it's good.
It's crowded.
Okay, do you think the line is worth the wait? Like, out of your thoughts, do you think it's worth the wait?
Yes, maybe.
Depends. I heard they have ice cream. I won't say, but I don't have money.
Okay, thank you. Hi, I'm Aubrey Shuping, and I'm here with
Emily Bowie.
Okay, what do you think of the student store?
I think it's very crowded because there's a lot of people, but I feel like it's very convenient.
Okay. Do you think that they have good food?
I'm not sure. I haven't ate any of the food yet, but I have a feeling they're going to be really good food.
With the selections of the food, do you think it's good?
Yes, very good.
Okay, thank you. Hi, I'm Aubrey Shuping. I'm here with
Alana
and Camden.
Okay, what do you think about the student store?
I enjoy it. I think it's a good way for kids to get snacks on their lunch.
Okay,
I think that there are like a lot of cool things that you can buy and just great snacks to kind of get you through the day, you know, that you don't get every day.
Yeah. Okay, do you think the line is worth the wait or no?
100%.
For sure. Uh-huh. I mean, the Rice Krispie treats are the best.
Oh, yes.
Really? Okay, thank you.
So, what do you guys think of the student store so far?
Oh, I like it. They have good snacks and drinks.
Yeah, everyone's saying the Gatorade Zero is nasty, but it's actually really good.
I love it. It's pretty good. The Snickers especially.
It's so cool that there's such a big variety of snacks.
I know. I'm so thankful we have such great parents that help out.
Yeah, I know. Now we have a skit about the rules with Miss Alicia that I'm excited to see.
Let's snap to the clip.
Hey, buddy. What you doing?
Oh, nothing.
Yeah, you have your phone out. You're not supposed to use your phone during school time. You'll have to go to the office.
Okay. Leave your cell phone in your backpack.
Wow, that was great. Now I know not to use my phone during breaks or lunches.
In addition to cell phones, Miss Alicia says after this week, we can no longer put our skateboards in the office, but we can lock them up.
By the way, you spellers out there, don't forget to turn in your spelling bee permissions slips by next Friday.
We'll be right back.
Well, that's the end of our show for this week.
We hope you enjoyed the first Roadrunner Report of the school year.
Have a great weekend. Bye. Aubrey, did you hear that Aaron interviewed Miss Emmrich this
week?
No,
I didn't. Was it interesting? Sorry.
Yeah, she's been teaching for 5 years. Let's cut to the clip.
3, 2, 1.
So, your name is Miss Emmrich, right?
Yeah, Aaron.
Hey, Roadrunners. By the way, it is one of our e-journalism people's birthdays today. Happy birthday, Michaela.
Thank you.